On today's CoinMarketCap tutorial, we will learn how to connect our MetaMask wallet to the BNB chain. Once we have MetaMask and the BNB chain all linked up, then you can use all of the services that are already on the BNB chain. Services like PancakeSwap, Venus, and so much more. Make sure you check out the timestamps in the description of this video to easily navigate through this tutorial. And if this is your first time here, my name is Rodney, and here at CoinMarketCap, we are on a mission to make cryptocurrency more accessible all around the world. That is why we love making videos for you that are packed with information, easy to understand, and simple to share with your friends and family. And if you want something more than just hype and you actually want to learn about crypto, make sure you hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications so you never ever miss an upload. And without further ado, let's learn together. This is how you connect MetaMask to the BNB chain. So the first thing we're going to need to do is open up our MetaMask wallet. Once we have that open, we can see that by default, we are already connected to the Ethereum mainnet. This is the network up here. We want to be connected to the BNB chain, obviously, right, for this video. So we're going to go ahead and click on that, go down to add network. And once you press that, another window is going to pop up. Now, in order to get onto the BNB chain, we're going to need to plug in some things here on this page. So for this example, I'm going to be using CoinMarketCap's Alexandria article on how to connect MetaMask to the BNB chain. And of course, I'll include a link to this article in the description box down below. So about halfway through the page, we are going to find everything we need to plug into MetaMask in order to access the BNB chain. So we'll go ahead and copy the network name, paste that right here, the new RPC URL, paste that here, the chain ID, which is 56, the symbol, which of course is BNB, and then the block explorer URL. So once we have everything ready to go, we're going to go ahead and press save. And voila, just like that, we are now on the BNB chain. So now, how are we going to put BNB into our wallet? There are so many different ways to get BNB into your MetaMask wallet. But for this example, I only think it's appropriate that we use the Binance exchange. After all, we are using their blockchain. Now, of course, on any exchange, you're going to need to fund it somehow, whether that's a checking account, a debit card, credit card, whatever the case, you need to get money on your exchange. Once you get money on your exchange, you need to swap for BNB. Once you have BNB in your account, then you can send it directly to your wallet and it's super easy. So I'm going to go down and click BNB. So in this account, I currently have 0.153 BNB, which equals about 55 USD. I'm going to go ahead and send some of that to my wallet right now. I'm going to go ahead and click withdraw. Now I'm going to enter the amount I want to withdraw. So I'm going to do about 0.1. That seems about right. Next, you need to enter the recipient address, which is just your wallet address. So we're going to go back to our MetaMask account, and right under the name for your wallet, you're going to see your wallet address. We're literally just going to copy that to our clipboard, go back to Binance and paste that in the recipient address. Then we're going to review our withdrawal. We'll go ahead and confirm it. So once you've done all the verifications you need to, it's going to say withdrawal pending. And then what you should see is some sort of deduction from your portfolio. And we can go ahead and keep looking at our MetaMask account to see when that BNB pops up. And after a few short minutes, just like that, we have BNB in our wallet ready to rock. Now, of course, I have a little less than what I sent because of the fees and those sorts of things. So next, we're going to actually swap our BNB using PancakeSwap. Make sure whenever you're connecting your wallet to any website that you double, triple, quadruple check to make sure that it is the correct website. So many people connect to a scam website and end up getting their entire wallet wrecked. Do not let that happen to you. Do your due diligence. Now, what I like to do is I like to go to CoinMarketCap and I'll go ahead and type in PancakeSwap. So once PancakeSwap pops up, I'll click on that. And of course, PancakeSwap is the swap that we use for BNB. Now there's others, but this is the main one. And right here, I can find the actual website. So if I click on that, it's going to take me to the correct website. Now, once I get to the correct website, I like to favorite it. So now every time I want to go to PancakeSwap, I can go check my favorites and I know for sure I'm going to the correct website. Once I'm here, I'm going to connect my wallet just by pressing connect. Then we're going to see a little wallet connect menu. I'm going to click MetaMask because that is my wallet. As you can see right here, I have a few different accounts, but I'm going to connect the appropriate account that I want to use. I'm going to click next, connect, And just like that, I am connected to PancakeSwap.finance. Now I'm going to go over to the trade tab, go to exchange, click on that. And once I'm here, now I can swap my BNB. For this example, I'm going to be swapping for Binance USD, which is a stable coin that is pegged to the United States dollar, and it's one for one. As you can see right here, it's close to the value of a dollar. So once you're back on PancakeSwap, you're going to see that your balance is automatically loaded right here, right? This is how much BNB we have in our wallet. Just to double check, you can see right here, we have 0.0995, and that reflects right here. So now I'm going to go to this drop-down menu at the bottom and click on BUSD, which is the stable coin that we just talked about. So for this example, I'm going to swap about 0.05 BNB, and that equals to about 18 BUSD. Once I'm ready to swap, I'm going to go down and press swap. It's going to ask me if I want to confirm that swap, and of course I want to. Then it's going to open up my wallet, where this is going to give me the gas fees for the total transaction. Now, the crazy thing about the BNB chain is that the gas fees are so cheap compared to the Ethereum blockchain. This is why so many people like using BNB and other blockchains, just because it's cheaper and faster sometimes. So now that we know exactly what the gas fees are, now we want to confirm the transaction. Once we confirm the transaction, it's going to take some time to swap. Now it's going to ask us if we want to add BUSD to our MetaMask wallet. And just like that, the transaction's already done. But we're going to go ahead and add the BUSD to our MetaMask wallet so we can see it in our actual wallet. We're going to go ahead and click this down here. Once we click that, it's going to open up our MetaMask wallet, and it's going to say, hey, do you want to add this token? You're going to put add token. And if you go back to your MetaMask wallet, you're going to see that you had the 18 BUSD where it should be. Congratulations, you are now a BNB chain expert, and you can go ahead and roam the world of DeFi and purchase any BNB project you see fit. So let us know what you think in the comments down below. Was this video helpful for you? If so, make sure you subscribe to the channel and make sure you hit that notification bell so you never ever miss an upload. Make sure you drop a like for Crypto Doggy, and we'll talk to you soon.